fundamentally more people are moving to cities, and whether this is Sao Paulo or Beijing or Mumbai or Singapore, and it's actually putting a lot of pressure on the underlying systems in cities. So the roads, the public transit, buses and trains, and more importantly, the commuters who are commuting every single day. So we're looking at how do you use technologies, a combination of spatial insights and also behavioral incentives to change this the ongoing sort of problem, this growing problem.
And I think the first sort of such moment was just noticing that cities deal with congestion by regulating road or transport network use, and they do this by sort of increasing charges. This is the economic way of driving away demand when there's an excess of it. And then you soon realize that this solution is not easy to sell. Commuters don't like to be paying something for something that they haven't had to do before. And then the aha moment was, could we incentivize commuters? Could they be given monetary incentives or social incentives for nudging their behaviors? And so that's, for example, aha moment.
Fundamentally, when you're looking at analog data, there's a whole bunch of new things that need to be solved in that context. So on the data processing side, in terms of scale, in terms of the new algorithms that actually can help us understand that data a lot better, and also the visualization systems that actually can help us get much more deeper insights into both the spatial side as well as the behavioral side. So essentially what we're doing is we're building out new systems that are much higher scale and dealing with this new class of data and also visualizing that to give fundamental insights to people. So what we are looking for are people who have a shared passion of making urban living better and also building out these new systems that have not been done before.